We have bumpers too, so that's working with wood too.
So we're gonna all.
All right, so Luke and Jeffrey move over.
We're gonna add chain and electronics to the drivetrain, and that will be led by Chris Christian. Okay, so Ethan will be doing it, and John, I think he's working on it. We get the CAD, and if Jason comes today, he'll be working on CAD. I'm gonna be working on CAD. Once you guys have your scalar prototype, the first prototype, you should go CAD it, and we have another laptop
with
CAD.
You take
Jason's been working on, and the scaler, Ryan, when you're
Jason coming today?
I'm not sure. And then you also need to add the shooter to the drivetrain to see how that
works. The shooter in relationship to the hopper is where? It's underneath it? Yeah.
Yes, because it has to fall from the hopper into the...
So how much height do you need on the shooter? I think to be clear from the hopper.
And finishing the bumpers, I'm going to have Zoe on that and Lauren.
Tuesday.
Yeah, Gavin, Jason's I'm going to have you work on fixing the FLL table because that would also give you an outreach credit towards travel.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because once the table's taken apart, you can put a little thing that goes down like this. You need to put a spacer on this. On what?
Do you dance?
As long as you got the blade off the wood.
Center on this thing. Are they supposed to be loose like this?
No. This side.
We're here with Aaron Piacciatelli. Aaron, as co-captain of the Minotaur team, how are you breaking up tasks this year?
Since the first day of kickoff, we started breaking up tasks into the different subdivisions of the robot, not based on like electronics or anything like that, but more based on what we want the robot to do. So we have a group working on the gear manipulator, a group working on the drivetrain, a group working on the shooter, and a group working on the scaler.
Wow. How's that working out?
It's worked out pretty well. We already have some prototypes down for pretty much all of the different tasks. We're on our second prototype for the shooter, and we're working on a couple different prototypes for the gear mechanism and the scale.
Circular
holes.
You know what that chain is for?
Yeah, the
This is what the public sees.
So we have a group working on the gear manipulator, a group working on the drivetrain, a group working on the shooter, and a group working on the scaler.
Okay, the master link is sort of bad, but we're gonna roll with it.
Maybe. It's pretty big.
It's really big. I mean, I thought that just a single strand of that power cord would be sufficient.
I will help you in 1 second.
You need it literally this right now.
Okay.
So you need to get screws and you need screws.
What kind of screws?
Either 832 or 832.
Got wheels of its own. That already makes it better than the other one.
Actually, you know what you do? Make it easier for you? Think about mounting this on the side. What about if we do this? So we got this.
All right.
Now, I know
why
even if it was regular season, it needs to be programmed because there's certain. He writes out a piece of paper. I'm going to send you this and I'll. Inevitably results in strip sprockets, right?
Just taking out the power is not.
What?
Ruins.
No, fix Ruins headphones.
Oh.
And then give him this measurement.
Yeah. What? Jason, you can text Jack those measurements and he can cut them down, but he only has the 1x2.
I'm gonna do the next one.
Andrew, I made some edits.
But we have five sites, Radius Innovation and Development. And it's owned by a company called Jable here in this area.
Okay, we're gonna take this, we're gonna move it.
You know, regular speed and then hard speed. Because theoretically, our tech rule will work all the way across, right? And each side, okay? So we're just trying to identify if there's any issues.
Yeah,
that's right.
What's this?
Give us a time on this.
You know, like FIT live. Yep. And really,
the goal is that. Give you the new space. What's your focus?
I just need to figure out how I'm attaching the Lexan to that. The doors are
calm in my flat. Oh my god, so. Alright, let's. Let's make a small little
It's not there, though.
Not yet. She's probably going to be here at around 12 till 13.
All right, Gavin, Ryan, you guys need
to go. All right.
Oh, wait.
So what are we doing today? What do we need?
All right, so checking in the battery box. So the battery box fell off? Oh, no. No, the battery, we took it off purposely because how it was, the balls were getting compressed too much.
It was not fast enough.
Close to us.
Oh, I don't
know. I know in New Orleans.
This is for whatever reason. Yeah. Social media had blown up with llamas because there's like llamas loose in a parking lot in Phoenix or something like that. So this happened, I don't know, the day
New
after
Orleans
that
was a good time.
Oh, there's one for the.
That's a vent. That's not a relief. I've lived here too, and I know it blows up. Primarily because I come to robotics and work outdoors in January every month. I gotta tell you, normal weight just drops right in.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interfere with your testing process. The battery box? Can you hand me the battery box? It's right there. This piece goes there. But yeah, square it up there.
It's a flat head, but it's
and
not
then
actually
the one by one back in.
Yes, it's 11 inches.
From the bottom of the frame. And same with all of these parts.
Okay. You know, you kind of see where the wire is coming out at?
Yep.
Okay. I want you to. I want you to hit it about right here, and we're going to work it to the corner back here.
Right on the front?
Yeah. Hold it up, hold it up. And go ahead.
Okay. Dang.
Just like that.
That's so cool.
Now, you felt me moving you around. That's
yeah.
I'm weaving it to keep the heat distributed because this stuff is so thin. We're set on 1/8 inch. It's a 1/16. If we're not moving quick enough, go right through it.
Yeah.
Wow. See, that's pretty cool. It's hard to explain that to someone, but if you're actually doing it for him, he's going to...
I had his hand on there. He could feel me going back and forth with it and kind of walking it.
But that's
cool. But if you look at
cool.
it, you can see it wasn't a very big walk. It's just enough to distribute the heat.
Wow.
This is our one, right?
That's fine. You can take that one off. Guys, that's the one that goes up there. What we just have to do is we got to take... It's fine. It didn't, wasn't that hot.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Alright, let's grab one of the clamps that we had.
Big one.
Alright, so we're going to weld this one out for the start. We're going to weld it right here in between this guy without hitting the chain.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to guide you.
Alright.
Come around over here, pull the trigger just a little bit more. Get the wire to move. Do you see the wire?
Pull it.
There you go.
Alright.
So that's where we're gonna start at. Okay.
Pull it.
Let's go.
Come on, stop.
Sorry. It's not you.
Oh.
I was see how I burned it out.
Can you see anything that goes?
It still actually gave us what we wanted. It's still connected.
Okay.
But
it's green until it bright light shines.
The backside there. Alright. I'll give you one more over here. Let's come around this way.
Okay.
You're gonna have to reach in, make sure you don't touch that wall.
Yeah.
Okay, a little bit more, give me some more lead on the top. Okay. Now this one will be a little bit more difficult for me because I can't see as well. Go ahead. And stop. That was it?
Alright,
that quick, that easy.
Well, everyone, thanks a lot for this is the FRC 1369 Team Minotaur, and today we're going to do Are You Smarter Than a Freshman? Aaron Piacitelli is leading this up, so Aaron, would you like to go ahead and start us off?
Okay, the first question is, what does FIRST stand for? Freshman, answer.
For Inspiration and Recognition of Science and Technology.
That is correct.
Good job. Woo! One for the freshmen.
Mentors, who powers FIRST at every level?
One power.
Mentors.
That is incorrect. The answer is volunteers.
Oh, oops, it looks like we're still at one for the freshmen and zero for the mentors.
Freshmen, what grades can participate in FRC?
9th through 12th grade.
That is correct.
Woo!
Oh,
mentors,
so smart.
Where was Dean Kamen born?
Sounds good. Mars.
That is incorrect. He was born in Long Island, New York.
Ooh, good try though. Good try.
Pretty close. Freshmen, how many weeks is the competition build season?
6 weeks.
That is correct.
All right, freshmen. 3 for the freshmen.
Mentors, in what year did Dean Kamen found his first medical device company?
I would say that's probably 1979.
That is incorrect. The correct answer is 1976.
Oh, that was a close one.
And you said you were good at trivia.
Is that ad-libbing in there?
Freshman, what does FRC stand for?
First Robotics Competition.
That is correct.
Good job.
Mentors, what year was Dean Kamen awarded the Medal of Technology?
That's made up. There's no Medal of Technology. 1976.
That is incorrect.
Oh.
The answer is 2000.
Hello, my name is Jack McFarlane. I'm one of the co-captains for the FRC 1369 Minotaur team. We spend a lot of time using the CNC mill and the lathe, and those are machines that the engineering program at Middleton allows us to use because they're used in the courses that they offer. So we kind of use those to make sure that all our our parts are precise. We also have a decently sized plasma cutter that we use to cut different pieces that we put onto our robot. We usually all have manufacturing there because we have so many different types of tools there and a lot of open space. We're currently here in week 5 of the FRC build season. We're just making sure our competition robot works. We're basically making sure that all the components, such as the scaler, which scales like a 2-foot rope, and our shooter all work together, and then making sure that our game manipulator works in that system. Basically, we spent the last 3 weeks making sure that everything fits together, and making sure that all the CAD and whatnot flows. So today we came to the scrimmage hosted by Royal Robotics, and we basically did a lot of diverse practice using the gear pegs they have here and the full field that they have set up. So we're just testing all the different drivers, and then we also got our practice bot to work. We also have more practice with driving and shooting. They don't have a davit set up, so we can't exactly test scaling, but we have our drivers are doing a lot of gear runs. We also had a lot of practice with our pilots being able to lift up on an actual airship, and our loaders being able to load down an actual loading station. And it was also good for our drivers to be able to practice with a lot of balls on the field and having the hoppers there, which we don't usually have at our school. So being having that spring and having the actual like realistic demo, we were able to see where we need to actually place it on the peg. So today was a lot of fun because a lot of people got to have hands-on experience with the practice robot. Like Avery was working on getting the electrical system, which he did quite successfully. John was helping him, and Andrew was working on the shooter. We also had Voon, Chinar, and Ezekiel working on the programming, which was very successful in getting it to go smoothly. We had Brianna, so for driving, we also got a lot of practice on Brianna, Fritz, Ethan, and Jared. And then loading, we had a lot of experience on Luke, Ethan, Voon, and Gavin. Today was a pretty successful day, and I think we all had a lot of fun.
Good afternoon! FRC 2017, SteamWorks!
FRC Minotaur 1369 co-captain.
And I'm Jack McFarlane, the other co-captain of Team 1369 FRC. Today is the final day of the FRC build season. We are in week 6, so today is the bag day. So we're basically bagging the robot today, and then we're going to move into what we consider the competitive season, which is about like 7 weeks of just competition. So we compete in week 1, which is at Palmetto in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
Week 4, we will be in Huntsville, Alabama for the Rocket City Regional. And then hopefully we'll be going to Houston, Texas for the world. Today we've had to do a lot of stuff, which mostly revolves around making sure the competition robot is ready to be bagged. And we're also weighing it to make sure that we know how much it weighs so that when we go to competition, we're not surprised.
We still have a lot of work ahead of us because we're gonna be working on the practice robot using that for driver's practice and programming practice so that when we go to competitions, we're more prepared.
We're also gonna bag some stuff with the robot that is not actually going to be part of the robot, it will be part of the robot, but it'll be used for other things as in like spare parts for the robot, because then it doesn't add towards our 30 pounds, which we'll be bringing. In the 30 pounds, we're gonna bring the shooter and the hopper and a few other things.
I'm really excited for this season because I think we've done a really good job this year. I think we were able to create a robot that was able to do most of all the game tasks, and something that we have really strived to do this year, and we've really worked really hard.
Yeah, we put a lot of heart into the season, and our gear manipulator and our timer work really well, and those will hopefully secure us a lot of points during the games.
It's also been quite an adventure just as being FRC captain, because it's something that we're not usually used to, as we kind of have to face a lot of new challenges, whether that's gaining the respect of our teammates, whether that's coming up with new design challenges, whether that's just handling a large team.
But it's all been fun. The hardest fun we've ever had. We have competition season now.
Yep, now we test our robot to see how well we are at going.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna fix this with the power of my mind.
Yeah, wait, don't we have a press here?
For whatever reason, social media had blown up with llamas because there's like llamas loose in a parking lot in Phoenix or something like that. because there's like llamas loose in a parking lot in Phoenix. Because there's like llamas loose in a parking lot in Phoenix. Because there's like llamas loose in a parking lot in Phoenix.
You.
That's not correct. That's not correct. It's Junior FLL. Oh.